Welcome to the Games Freezer.
Hello, it is Richard. It's Games Freezer. It's a 10-minute taster, and it's Phantom Trigger on Steam at the minute. This game immediately kind of reminds me, just kind of looks-wise and in a way, in the way it plays as well. It reminds me of Dead Cells, if you've played that. It's got that same kind of aesthetic as Dead Cells. It's tough as nails as well, which seems to be the trend at the minute. Nice retro looking graphics, retro inspired. So we start in the kitchen, you're talking to your wife, and then you pass out. It's kind of a bit of a dramatic start for old Stan. And then it fades out, and then you'll end up in this kind of neon world. It's quite an interesting first few minutes of the game. You don't really expect that, but it's pretty cool. I like it. So you end up sort of on this kind of wharf where your boat lands or floats to. Assuming that's you, assuming that's Stan, you don't really know anything yet. So you have a little explore around here, and you come across this this Toad guy. Not Toad from Super Mario Bros, but some kind of rhino-looking creature. Some like big lizard thing, dinosaur maybe, not sure. So you look like you're a woman because of the ponytail, etc. Basically, you're in this kind of world where Toad mentions that others come to and normally die. So it's a bit bleak. So then you come across this girl called Ant, who's an explorer, and she's standing in front of that portal there. So that portal's what you kind of use to go and have adventures and sort of fight things. This is kind of a hub world where we're in at the minute. Talking to this character called Tree. It's kind of cool looking character with all the tree bits coming out of her hair. And she gives you the sword that you're going to need. So it's an extra attack, really. It's basically you're starting with some kind of whip, but then you end up with this cube of ice, which gives you another more powerful attack that you'll be able to use against stronger enemies. So that's what I'm using here, that blue swish. So then you have a little look around this hub world, see what else is there. Not too much more. There's a couple of other characters over here that I'll take you over to. So who have we got? I've got this big old dude sharpening this massive sword. He needs more flint. So I'm kind of guessing that within the portal, there'll be some kind of quest or discovery of flint in there. And this guy here, this rabbit, he's a chef. So he wants some spices for his food. So, okay, so let's see what we can do. Let's see if we can find some other characters to have a look at or chat with. It's kind of a, is that a kind of, not a pentagram, but some kind of astrological chart on the floor or something like that. And that looks like a kind of tent set up or some kind of a tunnel or whatever. But let's go through the portal now. Let's see what's beyond. This is where the game sort of introduces you to the fighting mechanics. So those kind of crystals you can break down, they're the blue crystals that you can break down. You can't seem to break down the other crystals though. So I'm using this dash mechanic to go through the fire, and that's with X. Okay, right, we've got our first enemy, some kind of bulbous-headed thing Looks like it's a out of Last of Us. Oh, just went straight into the bloody fire there. There we go. So yeah, you're generally using that sword attack at the moment. And you got the whip attack, like I say. So there's this little short puzzle here to solve. So that's using the whip. I've whipped the cube that way. Ah, balls. Just ran myself over. That wasn't very clever, was it? There we go. Alright, so we've opened the door. That point there was a save point. So we come to some more crystals. We can't break the green ones, so I won't bother. And we're going to come to another set of enemies in a minute. So let's see what we can do with this lot. So now we've got these telehead guys as well. So you kind of think that maybe this is sort of going on in Stan's head. You know, that's what I'm thinking. He's sort of passed out. And is he in a coma or in between life and death maybe? Not sure yet, but yeah, it's kind of surreal. Kind of a mix between Dead Cells, maybe a little bit of Hotline Miami, sort of, in the neon aesthetic that he uses, you know. It's fun though, it's enjoyable. I haven't got too far on it. I've managed to, I had to notch down the difficulty from hard, which it comes in at, the default setting of hard. And we've got some bouncy gunk balls now. Oh, he's dealing with me. Got to time it, pal. It's all about time. Oh, you got to get out of the way of that. So when you hit him and he's about to die, he'll explode and he'll take life off of you. So let's go in here. I think there's some kind of life-restoring kind of mirror thing. Here we go. Got to hold down X for longer than that. That's it. Better restores my blue health bar, so that is all good. Well, I'm not too sure what the green health bar does actually. I'll have to find that out. Maybe there's something to do with the whip. I'm not sure. So you can you can pull enemies towards you with a whip, and then basically finish them off. But I did a bad job of doing that. So let's go again. So when you start again and you die, which you will die quite often, you will lose any progression from the last checkpoint. So you don't go back in with this same XP that you had already. So I leveled up, didn't I, when I was playing just then. So as I go back through, I'll need to level up again, assuming that I'll survive that long. Ugh. Come on. Right, let's get this telly dude. So the sword attack requires you to get in quite close. So that's why I'm leveling up again. Good stuff. That's why I'm losing a bit of health there, because I'm having to get in quite close. You string three together and by that time you normally get a retaliation from whoever you're fighting. Right, let's get in here and beat these bloody balls of gunk. Whoa. So he's leaving a trail of stuff behind him. And if I touch that, that'll take life off me. So the range attack for the television head guy is some kind of laser that locks on. So you can kind of move out of the way. You can use these cue of noise to make sure that you get out of the way in time. As soon as you hear that noise, you're out of there, basically. That's it. Use the whip to get these little one-eye bat things or whatever they are. Right, okay. Now let's go and power up again. We can use that mirror again. I like these kind of little touches around the level as well, like the candles on the floor. They're pretty cool. Yeah, and there's all like little details in the scenery that I do like a lot. Kind of good pixel art style. Okay, so right, we're past that bit that we didn't get past last time. So this is Ant again. We saw her outside, didn't we? So yeah, so kind of touching on the madness themes as well. So this part here, I'm kind of assuming that I have to hit the tower that shows up last and then beat these enemies up in order to open that gate. That's what I'm assuming. But at this point in time, I haven't managed to get past it. And I'm not sure where I'm going to this time either. Ooh. Come on. Yeah, get in there. Right, okay. So if I stand on here, so do I hit the one that blinks last and maybe work my way around the poles in order that I beat each pole in succession? Leveled up again, nice. Come on, Telly-Ed, what you got? Oh god, probably more than me because I haven't got much life left now. Shit. Come on. Yes, managed to survive that, but I haven't got much in the way of life. Oh, mate. This ain't gonna happen, is it? Oh. Come on. Oh, God. I can do this. You need to use the dash more often to get out of tricky situations, because that's what it's there for. So I must remember that. Come on. Yes, got you, you twat. Oh, bugger. Right, that's it. That's Phantom Trigger. I like it. I'm going to get stuck into it. I'll probably be tearing my hair out, but there you go. You give it a CRR, you are tough as nails, me. This is Richard.
www.gamesfreezer.eu